This is Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you.
Good morning, 5 o'clock, June 16th. I'm Ray Collins. It is Friday in more ways than one. Jacqueline is off today. John Scalzi is off today. Josh Stone is here, though, in Weather Center. Josh, good morning to you.
Good morning. In from the bullpen today, right?
That's right. The right-hander, right?
There you go. Mm-hmm. Or ambidextrous. Anyway, yeah. Let's check out the weather right now. It is going to be a pretty nice day, and then by this afternoon, a few showers and storms. You know the drill. I mean, we live in Florida, so that's what happens in the summertime. Let's check it out right now. 73 degrees, few clouds out there, humidity. Wow, 93%, so it's going to be another humid day for us. Zeroing in on the radar, a few scattered showers out there in the Gulf of Mexico, maybe the mouth of the Tampa Bay area. You're driving over the Sunshine Skyway going northbound. You may run into some wet weather there. But for the most part, everything looking fairly tame, and looks like there will be a change in our weather as we get into the next several days. We'll talk more about it when I return. Back to you.
All right, talk to you soon. Thank you. Checking the roads first off in Manatee County. A relatively high number of delays already at this hour of the day. State Road 64 in the westbound lane. Also 301 northbound heading toward downtown Bradenton. Farther south on the maps now in Sarasota County. Nothing to report right there. And farther south, we'll check the final map this morning. All clear at 5:02 on your Friday morning. Well, this story is just into our newsroom moments ago. A developing story overseas. Russia is claiming it has killed the leader of the Islamic State group in an airstrike. The raid was carried out on May 28th on a command post where ISIS leaders were meeting. The leader was reportedly taken along with several senior group members. The strike came as ISIS leaders gathered to discuss the group's withdrawal from the group's de facto capital. We'll have more on the story throughout the morning. Well, it was bipartisan baseball last night in the nation's capital. A softball game among Congress went on despite one of the members in the hospital from a shooting the day before. An update now from ABC's Stephanie Ramos.
The annual congressional baseball game in Washington, pitting Democrats against Republicans, hit a home run last night. The first pitch thrown by Capitol Police Officer David Bailey. He was hit by gunfire Wednesday morning when 66-year-old James Hodgkinson started shooting at Republican congressmen and staff gearing up for batting practice at a ballpark in Alexandria, Virginia. The suspected shooter reportedly angry with the Republican Party and the president, firing at Congressman Steve Scalise, who remains in critical condition.
Steve Scalise, this hat's for you.
The injured showing up to support, the first family also there, but the president making his appearance on the Jumbotron due to security concerns.
Tonight's game has taken on a much deeper level of meaning.
The game is a 108-year-old tradition. This year's event raising more than $1 million for charity and trying to send a message of unity despite the divisive political times.
When the speaker announced that we were going to do it, every Republican I know and every Democrat said that's the right thing to do. Everybody wants to play.
We want to beat those guys and they want to beat us, and afterwards we're going to give each other a hug and drink beer together.
The shooter's wife in Illinois emotionally speaking to reporters.
I had no idea this was going to happen, and I don't know what to say about it.
The shooting has raised questions about lawmakers' security. House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi says any changes will be up to the Capitol Police. But in times like these, when there's a large group of lawmakers around, she says security should be present. Stephanie Ramos, ABC News, Washington.
Back here at home, new details about a Bradenton man accused of stabbing his dog to death. This is the man, 19-year-old Joshua Cox, who is now facing animal cruelty charges. He was arrested early yesterday morning at a home on 19th Street West in Manatee County. Deputies first got a call from a neighbor who said Cox had asked for a shovel to bury the dog. Soon after, deputies found Cox in the yard. He confessed and even had a reason for his actions.
He told us that he killed the dog because he didn't want his dog to go to the pound. He had the dog since the dog was a puppy, and about 3 years. And it's just very, very sad because it's almost like he felt like there was no other recourse. But we had no other recourse other than to charge him with animal cruelty.
And they also charged him with possession of marijuana as well. New this morning, there's a shortage of deputies in Manatee County. The sheriff's office says it has 12 open positions in corrections and law enforcement. Also, deputies are needed in the eastern Manatee County area where there's been a boom in new home construction. A follow-up now on discussions in Manatee County to change the form of government. As our Rick Adams tells us, a charter government would offer more local control.
Well, many county officials and some city officials and residents were on hand for this workshop here at the Bradenton Area Convention Center. Manatee County is seriously considering becoming a charter county. They came to listen and to learn, from Manatee County commissioners to the sheriff and to many county and city officials. They were learning the ABCs of what it would mean to become a charter county.
We had citizens come to us and ask us about the possibilities of forming a charter for our government, and this was an opportunity to have education.
A charter county is guided by a document that provides counties with more power in their decision making. Supporters of charter government say this gives counties a lot more freedom from state restrictions. Barbara Elliott is president of Stone Soup Community Unity PAC. She's someone who's pushing hard for a charter government in Manatee County.
I believe that anything that makes a better democracy and gives more power to the people who live in their community is a good thing.
Currently, 20 of Florida's 67 counties are charter counties. Sarasota County has had a charter government since 1971. The Florida Association of Counties hosted this workshop, giving all in attendance a better understanding of what that means.
It's very much a grassroots effort. It comes from the bottom up, meaning from a community up, to actually create what their form of county government is going to look like.
Alvin Zimmer and his wife were some of the residents who were in attendance at this workshop. He tells us right now might be a good time for Manatee County to make this move.
It would be interesting. I think it would work. I believe our county commissioners would be for it.
And Manatee County officials tell us they will now discuss what they learned at this workshop and then decide what the next step will be. Reporting from Palmetto, I'm Rick Adams, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
A follow-up now on that crash that shut down the North Bridge of Siesta Key earlier this week. Police say the driver of one of the three cars involved has died. They say 57-year-old Guy Theron of Sarasota was speeding in a minivan when he swerved at the sharp turn at Heigl Avenue and hit two oncoming cars. Theron and three other men were all taken to the hospital. The three others are still hospitalized. Police believe that speed and a possible medical condition both contributed to that fatal crash. Also, more now about a serious motorcycle crash on North Trail at Myrtle earlier this week. Police say the driver, E.C. Snell of Bradenton, has died of his injuries. They say he swerved off the road and crashed into a pole. They don't believe that speed was a factor. That accident shut down part of 41 on Wednesday morning during the busy morning commute. On to education news now. The numbers are in from state standardized testing, and one Sarasota County school has seen positive results from a new reading program. Our Adam Cellini has the story.
When school ended last year, the teachers here at Emma E. Booker Elementary School asked the teachers union if they'd help fund an SRA reading program at the school. It's a unique system that advocates say helps students at Title I schools stay focused during reading lessons.
Last year, just 36% of third, fourth, and fifth graders at Emma E. Booker Elementary were reading at their grade level.
To say that one out of three is on grade level is unacceptable. To say that it's less than a coin flip about whether you can read or write.
When Eric Robinson won a Sarasota County School Board seat in November, he swore to give his $40,000 annual salary back to the district. When Emma E. Booker teachers came together and asked to bring back SRA reading, he pitched in $5,000 to help.
You need to listen to the teachers at the end of the day. They're the ones who are in the classroom with the students, and they have the most intimate knowledge about what's going to work in their classroom.
SRA programs put students in groups of similar reading levels and have them read out loud together through scripted lessons. More work for the teachers, but also allowing more instant feedback. Nancy Dubin used SRA for over 20 years as principal of Tuttle and Laurel Nokomis Elementary Schools.
We look at it kind of like the student's vitamin for the day. You know, it's an hour of a pretty intense lesson, but it really works.
This year's proficiency scores jumped a percentage point for third graders and 8% for fifth. But Laura Kingsley says there's no rush to adopt it countywide.
I think schools are waiting to see data. Some of the schools are very comfortable. The teachers are very comfortable with the program they provide. the reading instruction they provide and may or may not be interested in that.
The district is, however, committed to continuing the program at MAE Booker and earmarked $100,000 to keep it going until next spring.
The school district says they're still waiting on the learning gains data from the state, which hasn't been released yet. That'll show whether individual students made 1 year's growth or 2 years growth over the course of last year, and they say it's a more accurate measuring stick of whether or not this program is actually helping. In Sarasota, Adam Cellini, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
You've heard of ride sharing services like Uber. Now there's a car sharing service called the Zipcars. It's a new way to rent a car by the hour or by the day. You have to download an app and then you get access to one of 12,000 cars around the world. The Zipcar is right now being tested in Sarasota. It's based at the new Cityside Apartments in the Rosemary District. Another Walenda made news over Niagara Falls yesterday. The fifth anniversary of her husband walking across the falls on a tightrope, Erindira Walenda hung by her teeth under a helicopter 300 feet over the water. Nick was in the copter. He called her a ballerina in the air.
I, you know, looked up and I saw my husband smiling at me and he's like, "You got this, babe." I was like, "Yeah, you know what? That's right."
And today is another special day for the Walenda family. One of Nick and Erindira's sons graduates today as a U.S. Marine. Certainly causing quite a stir up there in the Niagara region. Every 5 years, a new stunt.
I know. It's amazing. These guys are just, I don't know if I could do that. I'm afraid of heights anyway.
I know I couldn't do it.
takes a lot of coordination.
It certainly does.
Anyway, our weather pattern is going to change. Remember a few days back, we had a day after day of clouds and showers and storms. That may be in our forecast in the near future. We'll talk about it when I return.
All right, 512 right now, still ahead. More troops are going to Afghanistan. The Pentagon hoping to break a stalemate with the Taliban. But first, from Bello to Mozart, a rundown of this weekend's activities in our Suncoast scene.
A promise was made, a promise that hit the beaches of Normandy, a vow that captured Iwo Jima, a contract that weathered Tet, a pledge that stormed the desert in Iraq, an IOU that braved IEDs in Kandahar. A promise was made to America's veterans. DAV fights to keep that promise so all veterans and their families get the benefits and support they earned. For help, visit DAV.org.
Rose takes her volunteering for Tidewell Hospice very seriously. But she knows how to have fun, too. And that's what she brings when we're invited to visit patients as part of Tidewell's pet therapy program. People love to see her. She really brightens their day. She makes people smile. And in end-of-life care, a smile can be a wonderful gift. Tidewell Hospice. It's more than you think.
Is your old garage door stuck or broken? Would a new one give you a lift? Let Precision Door Overhead Garage Door Service of Sarasota come to the rescue with prompt and affordable repair service. Replacement doors come with an array of styles and colors, and they are rated to meet and exceed Florida standards. From estimates to installation, your satisfaction is our priority. If you're not 100% satisfied with any product, service, or installation, we will make it right, because Precision Door Service is a name you can trust.
With a top prize of $10 million, the new $10 million world-class cash scratch-off from the Florida Lottery is your ticket to take on the world.
If you get knocked down, stand up again. Rip it up again. Give me one chance, I'm gonna make it, make it. Give me my chance, this is my chance, I'm gonna take it.
The new $10 million world-class cash scratch-off from the Florida Lottery. One of our life-changing scratch-offs offering billions in cash prizes.
If you've ever had a bad night's sleep, call it Price the new Kraft Matic Legacy. It has so much more than other adjustables and still costs up to 50% less. Featuring a rising adjustable pillow rest to support your head, neck, and shoulders, bedside power plugs, under-bed night lights, and more. So call it Price One today for less. Up to 50% less than Tempur-Pedic Sleep Number and other adjustables.
You get so much more and it still costs less. You got to see how little they cost.
Call 1-800-774-8103. That's 1-800-774-8103. Call now.
We'll be right back.
Okay, welcome back, everyone. I'm meteorologist Josh Stone in for John Scalzi on this Friday. Happy Friday to you. What can we expect today? Warm and humid conditions with a few clouds, then a few scattered showers and storms that will either take place in the morning and then maybe refiring in the afternoon, but those will be inland today. And then guess what? The southwest flow returns as we get into the latter part of this upcoming weekend into early next week. And with the southwest flow, more moisture tracks into the area, and that's going to help bring us widespread showers and even some thunderstorms. Check out our current temperatures right now, 73 in Sarasota, 72 in Mayakas City, 70 in Punta Gorda, so lower to mid-70s right now. Titan radar, not a whole lot going on around the state, but offshore, a few scattered showers, maybe some rumbles of thunder moving into the mouth of the Tampa Bay area, but as far as the rest of the activity pushing off into the Atlantic, we do have a few scattered showers in our forecast today. Some could pop up this morning, and then again, like in the afternoon, those storms would probably be inland and east of 75. But here's a little cell here that's pushing ever so slightly towards the Charlotte Harbor area, maybe around Gasparilla Island. Not a lot of moisture in the mid to upper levels of the atmosphere right now, but this will change as we get into the next several days with that southwest flow that will take place that will help to pump up more moisture into our area. And a trough that will dig in from the west will help to scoop up that moisture from the Gulf of Mexico right into our area. If you're taking an airplane out of SRQ today, looks like all the airports, Atlanta, LaGuardia, Chicago, and Charlotte, no real delays at all. Tropics are quiet. There is one slight little disturbance way out here in the southern Atlantic, but that only has about a 10% chance of development, so we're not worried about that. For the low tide, that will be at 12:38 p.m. For the beachgoers today, a few clouds, maybe a few sprinkles. Seas at 1 to 2 feet, light chop in the bays, 83 at the beach today. Just watch out for their showers and storms. Our high actually should top out around 87. And there you go for the next several days. Actually, the weekend looks okay for the first half. And then Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, more of that southwest flow moves in here, bringing more showers and storms to the area. Ray?
Again soon, there's the situation right now in Manatee County. Still a slowdown on 64 westbound. We'll watch that throughout the morning. Farther south now on the maps into Sarasota County. We'll check that and see already something at 41 northbound in Fruitvale. I glimpsed. There it is. So there's a bit of a situation there near the Van Wezel heading northbound. And then the South County map will show nothing right now at 519 on your Friday morning. Efforts are underway to help preserve a piece of history on Longboat Key while giving it new purpose as well. The Longboat Key Historical Society is looking to move two historic cottages on the key and make them their own permanent headquarters. One cottage will be turned into a museum, while the other would be a multi-purpose building. They will be moved from the Center for the Arts property to a lot on Broadway Street.
About 2.5 years ago, they were basically let go from the Whitney Beach Shopping Center, and the Historical Society has been boxed up in boxes ever since and is in somebody's garage at this point. So I felt compelled to try to get them a permanent home.
The group still must raise about $45,000 for the project before it can happen, and also they need permission from that planning commission as well. Well, you have a wide range of choices this weekend in the area. Our Linda Carson has the weekly Suncoast Scene.
Want to see Dad's eyes light up on Father's Day? Bring him to the Fathers and Fenders Car Show.
We usually have about 120 of the most fantastic cars in Sarasota that come out. So we'll have everything from Model A's till brand new Lamborghinis.
This beauty will be on display.
This is one of the five cars we'll be having down here. 57 Chevy Bel Air convertible, power brakes, power steering, factory color, mint, 100-point car. Beautiful. We'll probably have a Bentley, a Lamborghini, and a BMW M1.
One of those cars is worth $500,000. Fathers and Fenders, Sunday from 9 to 10 a.m. in Five Points Park in downtown Sarasota. A great way to entertain Dad on Father's Day, and admission is free. and two great concerts coming up this weekend.
The Sarasota Music Festival presents Shimmering Summer Friday night here at the Opera House and Mostly Mozart on Saturday night. Both concerts are at 8 p.m.
Brett Mitchell will conduct Saturday night.
There's a lot of Mozart on the program, which is kind of how the genesis began, which is the 40th symphony, which is one of the last three symphonies that Mozart wrote towards the end of his life, one of the very, very greatest symphonic works ever composed.
They'll also play a concerto by Mozart for a violin soloist. That will be faculty member Alex Carr. He says these music festival concerts will be a joy.
Live music is like nothing else in the world. You know, it's funny, you can always listen to a CD, and that's very nice, but to listen to live music, to people giving their hearts and souls to you every minute for an entire two-hour time, it's something that's pretty special to witness.
And Incredibello just opened at the historic Oslo Theater.
It has magic, illusion, singing, dancing, circus, all the arts.
Incredibello now at the historic Oslo Theater through July 29th. This man will make you laugh till you cry, and he'll leave you asking yourself, how did he do that?
How did I do that?
I was wondering that myself.
Me too. I'm Incredibello.
You gotta come see this guy. And don't miss Friday Fest. The Van Wezel starts its monthly presentations of Friday Fest on the Bay this Friday night. Admission is free. You can hear great music while you watch the sunset over this beautiful location.
We've got local favorite Doug Deming and the Jewel Tones bringing some rockabilly and blues. A lot of local vendors bringing great food and drinks and lots of other provisions for people. It's a free event. Bring your chairs, your blanket.
Linda Carson, ABC7, your Suncoast News.
All right, lots of choices. Thank you, Linda. Still to come, an on-demand shopping device making shopping on Amazon faster than ever. And be careful where you step on the beach. There's now a record number of turtle nests and yellow posts as well. That story at 5:38.
You love your couch and want to protect it from spills, food, and scratching, shedding pets. Introducing Couch Coat, the reversible, washable quilted cover that protects your couch. Shield against spills, wow, stop stains and dirty pet paws and sharp claws. Plus, it's reversible with two stylish colors, guaranteed to fit any couch up to 92 inches or your money back. It even has covers to protect armrests. Machine washable too.
My grandkids destroy everything. But with Couch Coat, my couch is always protected, looking as good as it did the day I bought it.
Get your Couch Coat for just $19.99. And it's reversible in brown and cream, like two Couch Coats for the price of one. Order right now and you can double your offer. Get a second Couch Coat. Just pay a separate fee. Order right now.
Call 1-800-943-0710 to get your Couch Coat. Call now or go to couchcoat.com. So call 1-800-943-0710. That's 1-800-943-0710. Call now.
The kitchen is where life happens. Minnesota Flooring now offers a wide variety of beautiful quality craft-made cabinetry to make sure the heart of your home reflects your style. Visit us today at our new kitchen and bath cabinetry locations.
That is a pretty good breakfast. You're not even eating.
Not hungry.
No? Why not? What's up?
Kath and I knew that Jenny had been partying a bit. Found out she tried heroin.
Most people don't know what to say about drugs, but we do. Visit us at drugfree.org.
Welcome back, 525 now. A man with several successful inventions already has plans to colonize Mars and send a million people. The latest on Elon Musk and more in this morning's Tech Byte report.
In today's Tech Bytes, Twitter's major overhaul.
Yeah, you might have noticed when you logged on today, it's the biggest redesign in years. The font is different, and now your profile image, like Candace's here, is round instead of square.
Yeah, but I'm still square. Twitter says it's faster and easier to use. Amazon wants to change the way, though, you buy groceries with the new Dash Wand. Scan a barcode, and it's then added to your Amazon shopping cart, or you tell Alexa to buy it for you.
The cost is $20, but it comes with a $20 credit, so it's like it's free.
It's free.
And billionaire Elon Musk has published his ambitious plan to colonize Mars.
The SpaceX founder is now sharing his four-stage process to inhabit the red planet. His goal, to send up to 1 million people there within the next 50 to 100 years.
Would you live on Mars?
I would let you go first.
Okay, I would try it. Might be cool up there.
Okay, you
the
first.
Air up there. Those are your Tech Bytes.
Have a good one.
Tech Bytes, brought to you by Zelljanz.
Your body was made for better things than rheumatoid arthritis. Before you and your rheumatologist move to another treatment, ask if Xeljanz is right for you. Xeljanz is a small pill for adults with moderate to severe RA for whom methotrexate did not work well. Xeljanz can reduce joint pain and swelling in as little as 2 weeks and help stop further joint damage. Xeljanz can lower your ability to fight infections, including tuberculosis. Serious, sometimes fatal infections, lymphoma, and other cancers have happened. Don't start Xeljanz if you have an infection. Tears in the stomach or intestines, low blood cell counts, and higher liver tests and cholesterol levels have happened. Your doctor should perform blood tests before you start and while taking Xeljanz, and monitor certain liver tests. Tell your doctor if you are in a region where fungal infections are common, and if you have had TB, hepatitis B or C, or are prone to infections. Xeljanz can reduce the symptoms of RA, even without methotrexate, and is also available in a once-daily pill. Ask about Xeljanz XR.
Are you Goodwill?
Yes, because when I donate
or shop at Goodwill,
I am creating a job.
I am Goodwill, yeah.
This is your brain. This is drugs. This is your brain on drugs. Any questions?
Yeah, I have questions.
Prescription drugs aren't as bad as street drugs, right?
Weed's legal, isn't it?
Drinking is worse than smoking weed.
Isn't it? Why
is heroin so addictive?
Molly just makes you feel happy.
I have questions.
Mom?
Dad, did you ever try drugs?
They're going to ask. Be ready. Go to drugfree.org. A message from Partnership for Drug Free Kids.
Rose takes her volunteering for Tidewell Hospice very seriously. But she knows how to have fun, too. And that's what she brings when we're invited to visit patients as part of Tidewell's pet therapy program. People love to see her. She really brightens their day. She makes people smile. And in end-of-life care, a smile can be a wonderful gift. Tidewell Hospice, it's more than you think.
I'm calling in regards about my mother, and I'm here, and I just want to thank you because it saved my mother's life yesterday. And I'd like to know the names of the people that came in and saved her so I could call and thank them. And she's doing fine. It's a wonderful thing. Thank you.
When you fall and cannot get up, an accident can turn into a tragedy, but with Life Alert, one touch of a button can get you help fast. Life Alert saves a person from a catastrophe every 10 minutes.
Life Alert is a lifesaver. If it weren't for Life Alert, I wouldn't be sitting here today.
For a free Life Alert brochure, call 1-800-962-4112. That's 1-800-962-4112. Call now, 1-800-962-4112. For a free brochure, call 1-800-962-4112.
We've all heard how military veterans adjusting to the civilian world may have certain issues.
30. 70.
If only everyone had this issue, no matter what challenge they face, Easter Seals is here for America's veterans.
Enjoy some of the best Suncoast restaurants on me.
Just go to mysuncoast.com/dining, sign up for the newsletter if you haven't already, and you can win a $50 gift card to a restaurant in our area. We'll pick a winner each week, so go on our website and sign up now.
Check out mysuncoast.com/dining, your guide to the foodie lifestyle.
The burden of danger is off, and that is the greatest relief we have.
After nearly 60 hours in the run, two inmates accused of killing prison guards are back in custody. How a new facility named after a famous artist is giving new hope to those with mental illness in Sarasota. And the man behind Margaritaville is looking to build on the Suncoast.
Live from the ABC 7 studios, this is Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you.
Good morning, 5:31 right now. I'm Ray Collins. Jacqueline is off today. John is also off. So Josh will tell us whether or not the weekend has any shot at sunshine. What's the story, Josh?
Well, we'll get to that a little bit later. But yeah, I mean, we're going to have some sunshine in our forecast, and then things start to change. We'll talk, like I said, more about that a little bit later. But let's check out the current right now. Current temperature is 73 here in Sarasota, 74 in Venice, 70 in Arcadia, 71 in Lake Placid. And there's a few scattered showers out here in the Gulf of Mexico. Maybe some rumbles of thunder, though I don't see any lightning strikes with these. Maybe around Longboat Key, Siesta Key, experiencing some sprinkles down in the Charlotte Harbor area. You're going to experience some light rain coming your way. But some showers and storms will develop once again in the afternoon. Those will be inland and highest of day topping out. Maybe this is more coastal temperatures, but inland will be in the mid to upper 80s. And we'll talk more about that rain chance coming our way when I return. Back to you, Ray.
All right, talk to you soon. Thank you, Josh. Checking Suncoast traffic night right now on this Friday morning. We'll start this time in Sarasota County. Or in Manatee County, where there's some issues on State Road 64 westbound, also north of the river as well, heading toward the interstate, and also out east, heading away from 64 on 75. Farther south now into Sarasota County, nothing to report there, and the final map to the south will show all clear at 5:32 on your Friday morning. Our top story this half hour, two escaped inmates who killed two jail guards were captured last night by a civilian with a gun. Inmates Donnie Rowe and Ricky DeBose were arrested last night in Tennessee. They're accused of killing two correctional officers in a Georgia prison van and then carjacking a driver to speed away. Their taste of freedom ended, though, when they tried to steal another car, but a homeowner and a neighbor held them at gunpoint until police caught up.
Yes, it feels good, but there's a lot of hurt people in Georgia that will feel the pain for years and years to come. Maybe we can give them a little closure now. I know after speaking with Director Keenan here just a few minutes ago that they're breathing a sigh of relief down there in Georgia, and we were obviously all very happy to be able to help them.
And the two inmates are now back in handcuffs and back in custody. In California, a huge drug seizure in San Diego. The Coast Guard collected 18 tons of cocaine. That's what it looks like. It comes after inspections of suspected drug smuggling vessels in Central and South American waters. Last year, the Coast Guard seized more than 400,000 pounds of cocaine and arrested nearly 600 attempted smugglers. The Pentagon will try to break the stalemate in Afghanistan by sending over 4,000 more troops. The U.S. is hoping to stop recent Taliban advances in the region. The additional troops will join another 8,000 already there. A U.S.-led coalition is advising Afghan combat units in the fight against the Taliban. Less than a year after the U.S. opened some doors with Cuba, the Trump administration plans to make some changes already. The president will announce a new policy today in Miami. Serena Marshall has this preview.
President Trump planning to outline a new course for Cuba later this morning, reversing some of the policies opened under President Obama. Among the changes expected, no more traveling to the island on the honor code, or a simple confirmation that you fall into one of those 12 pre-approved categories. Now you must prove it and keep your records of all transactions made in Cuba for up to 5 years. Much of the people-to-people travel will be recast through tour groups. And while cruises and airlines can remain, their services will likely be limited by this change. Under the relaxed regulations, Cuba saw a 74% increase in Americans traveling to Cuba in 2016 over the previous year. That will likely end, and with it, those flights. The administration also hoping to restrict money that flows to the Cuban military. What is expected to remain? The embassies and current policies on family travel and remittances. The administration says the basis for the changes are human rights. They want to see free and fair elections. Amnesty International and Human Rights Watch put out statements earlier this week saying they believe improved human rights will come from a greater opening, not closing, of Cuba. Serena Marshall, ABC News, Washington.
An update now on the Bill Cosby trial. Jurors left the courtroom last night after more than 40 hours of deliberations and still no verdict. They'll return this morning for a fifth day of talking about it outside that Norristown courtroom. One of Cosby's spokesmen hopes this long delay indicates Cosby won't be found guilty of sexual assault.
We believe that he's innocent. We believe that he's not guilty. And I think the jurors have shown that too.
If convicted on all three counts, Cosby could spend 30 years in prison. Back in this area, a new facility in Sarasota to help people with mental illness. The Vincent Academy is on Glengarry Street, which is on 41 near Bee Ridge Road. The 8,500-square-foot building offers vocational training and also job placement services. It's for clients who suffer from anything from post-traumatic stress to suicidal thoughts. According to a recent government figure, the unemployment rate for those with mental disorders is about 90%. The academy is named after the artist Vincent Van Gogh, whose own mental illness led to suicide at the age of 37. More and more sea turtles are nesting on local barrier islands. Over 1,200 loggerhead nests and 4 green turtle nests have been seen on Manasota Key alone. That's according to a new report from the Coastal Wildlife Club. Members also found the rare Kemp's Ridley nests. Moat Marine has reported over 1,300 nests from North Venice to Longboat Key. Turtles generally nest in Florida from June to late September. 5:37 right now. A piece of Margaritaville is coming to Bradenton. Jimmy Buffett is part of a new housing development on State Road 64 on the way out to Anna Maria Island. Developers plan to add 132 homes and a harbor with 2 restaurants and shops as well. Similar communities already exist in Daytona Beach and Hilton Head, South Carolina. Developers say it would be a natural to build here as well.
We've always had this coastal island architecture with a very laid-back, relaxed attitude. And as you know, Margaritaville is synonymous with escapism, fun, and the laid-back lifestyle. So we think it's a great match.
It's not cheap. Homes start at $400,000. It should be complete by next spring. A fun summer camp this week for kids who love baseball. Elementary and middle school students are learning about the game from the Bradenton Marauders themselves. The kids get to hit and field, even run the bases. It's taking place at the Lecom Park right there in the center of Bradenton. Meantime, some Wisconsin kids are jumping for a chance to get a job this summer, literally. It's called a mailboat jumper. The job is to deliver mail from a moving boat and from pier to pier. It's a tradition that's more than 100 years old, starting back in 1916. Only 6 spots are open and kids are trying to try out. They say it's a grueling test of speed, agility, and confidence.
The advice I always say is run faster than you think that you should be, because you'll be running and say, oh, I'll make it back, and then you'll turn around and the boat will be almost gone. I have not fallen in tryouts, period. I've fallen in 3 times total, but that was all during the season.
Mail jumpers make deliveries to 75 homes or boats every day during the summer. They also offer tours for spectators who just want a front row seat to watch the action. That looks like fun.
That's great.
Surprised that many folks still get mail.
I'm wondering if those kids also do the tennis balls, you know, running from one side of the court to the other.
Oh, yeah,
fetching
good idea.
Those. So, you know, you talked about rain.
I did.
And you asked me if there's going to be maybe more rain coming our way. And the answer actually is yes.
I thought so.
Yeah. So we're going to talk about that, break it down for you, and see if we can get some sunshine in our forecast. But it does look to be a little cloudy and rainy. So we'll talk all about it in a few minutes.
Okay, real good. Also, Florida is a great place for retirement, but you might be surprised where it ranks for taking care of retirees We'll have details next in HealthSmart.
Outdoor living is one of the greatest perks about living in Florida. So whether this is your style, or this, or maybe this, contact Superior Pools. They've been building pools from Sarasota to Naples since 2001, and they would love to build yours.
What to do when your heating or air conditioning needs service or, heaven forbid, replacement? Call Air Now today. We've been serving Sarasota and Manatee counties since 1946. We offer $49.95 tune-ups, lease or finance options, and remember, service today or it's free.
Need more space in your place? The More Space Place can help. With Murphy beds that disappear to reveal a home office, living room, or den. Custom closets with designated areas for your shoes, bags, wardrobe, and accessories. Custom-built entertainment centers, garage storage systems, and more. The More Space Place has three showrooms next to Sonny's on US 41 South in Sarasota, on Lakewood Ranch Boulevard just south of State Route 64 in Bradenton, and on Tamiami Trail next to Panera Bread in Port Charlotte. Put more space in your place at the More Space Place.
Today, everyone is looking for more fashionable choices in flooring than ever before. And G. Fried has responded with a huge selection of carpets, tile, wood, laminate, and vinyl. Installed by a highly skilled team, G. Fried has got everything you're looking for and more. The next time you think about quality flooring, think G. Fried Flooring America. G. Fried Flooring America. Our world is at your feet.
Are you Goodwill?
Yes, because when I donate or shop at Goodwill,
I am creating a job.
I am Goodwill, yeah.
At Tidewell Hospice, we know it's never too late to say thank you to our military veterans. The Tidewell Honors Veterans Program has provided care to more than 13,000 military families since 2008. Tidewell volunteers help honor veterans through special pinning ceremonies that demonstrate our appreciation for the freedom our veterans fought to defend. If you know a veteran who can benefit from end-of-life care, call or visit Tidewell.org today. Tidewell Hospice, it's more than you think.
What Florida city is best known for spaceflight?
Cape Carnival.
Cape Carnival? Close enough! What condiment includes vinegar, molasses, and anchovies?
Westchester sauce?
Close enough! And now, a word from our sponsors.
One off from the Florida Lottery. Now available for pick 2, 3, 4, and 5 games. Miss by one on any or all numbers and still win.
I'm calling in regards about my mother, and I'm here, and I just want to thank you because it saved my mother's life yesterday. And I'd like to know the names of the people that came in and saved her. It's a wonderful thing. Thank you.
With Life Alert, one touch of a button can get you help fast.
For a free Life Alert brochure, call 1-800-962-4112. That's 1-800-962-4112. Call now, 1-800-962-4112.
Outdoor living is one of the greatest perks about living in Florida. So whether this is your style, or this, or maybe this, contact Superior Pools. They've been building pools from Sarasota to Naples since 2001, and they would love to build yours.
Good to see you on this Friday. Wake up, everyone. I'm meteorologist Josh Stone in for John. He has the day off, and we're looking at a temperature of 73 degrees when you walk outside. Dew point 71. It's possible some areas inland could experience some patchy fog on this Friday morning, so look out for that on your morning commute. Humidity at 93%, not much of a wind, but winds are coming out of the southeast and east, about 3 to 5 miles per hour at this time. Okay, today, warm and humid, few scattered showers in the morning hours, then some thunderstorms will develop in the afternoon. Those will be inland, but look what happens as we get into next week. Southwest flow returns. Remember, not too long ago, we had a southwest flow that brought us day after day after day of showers and storms. Well, it looks like this could be in our forecast again, but that should start to ignite as we get into next Monday. And then once again, widespread showers and storms will be in our forecast. Right now, not so much. Some light scattered showers out here in the Gulf of Mexico, kind of just pixelating the area here. Maybe some light showers around Longboat Key, A few steady showers on the northern end of Siesta Key and around Rotunda. You're going to be experiencing some showers here not too long from now, but nothing really sustained as far as anything organized and producing any heavy rainfall. Mid to upper level moisture, not prevalent in this graphic. Of course, this is water vapor imagery, but this changes as we get into early to mid next week. Powerful storms raked through the Midwest late last night. These have now dissipated. The remnants, though, tracking towards maybe Chicago, edging towards Memphis. But for us, everything looks fairly quiet, fairly tame. Futurecast does show a few showers and storms will develop over the next several hours. I think the heavier storms will be inland today. And then for tomorrow, not a lot of moisture for these storms to develop, so I think everything's going to be very quiet. The tropics look very quiet at this time, though there is a little disturbance down here in the southern Atlantic. It's not even really on the map here, but only has a 10% chance of developing in anything. We're not worried about that. Taking your boat out today, low tide will be at 12:38 p.m., the high tide at 5:28 late this afternoon. Our high should top out around 87, closer to the coast, a little bit cooler than that, with a southeast becoming southwesterly wind, about 5 to 10 miles per hour. In the 7-day forecast, there you go. As we get into Father's Day, about a 30% chance of shower, so I think you'll be able to enjoy that day outside. But then Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday of next week, that southwest flow really kicks in, brings us more rainfall, right?
All right, thank you, Josh. Checking Suncoast traffic right now. On to health news. A new scorecard by AARP puts Florida toward the bottom when it comes to senior home health care options. Florida ranks 46th overall. According to the report, too many seniors are having to go to facilities rather than stay in their own homes. AARP says the major problem is a lack of funding. The director of Sarasota's Jewish Family Children's Services believes that the problem is people are moving to Florida to retire, but there's a lack of options for care given to them, and hourly pay for medical professionals is lacking.
New Jersey, I made 16-something. And they want to give me $8, and I was 30-some years certified already.
AARP says the state would have to add nearly $2 billion in the budget for senior care to catch up with the states in the top five of the ranking. Again, Florida is ranked 46th. A new study is showing people are eating less salt, but that does not mean they're eating healthier. Kim Hutcherson sorts it out.
Americans are consuming less salt, according to a study published in JAMA Internal Medicine. But the decrease is less about healthy choices and more about changes by manufacturers. Researchers examined data on packaged food and beverages purchased by 172,000 U.S. households. They found that between 2000 and 2014, the amount of sodium in the products Americans bought dropped 12% to less than 2,000 milligrams a day. But experts say that's still too much. The data also showed that less than 2% of American households specifically bought packaged food and drinks with ideal amounts of sodium. Most of the salt we eat comes from packaged foods and restaurant meals, which means it accumulates throughout the day. Adults should consume no more than 2,300 milligrams of salt daily, about one teaspoon. Ideally, it should be half that. But experts say most Americans ingest far too much, about 3,400 milligrams daily. Doctors recommend choosing low-salt foods, replacing salty snacks with fresh fruit, and keeping track of how much salt you consume. For today's Health Minute, I'm Kim Hutcherson.
If you like onions, researchers found that red onions have more cancer-fighting properties than white onions. Both contain potent antioxidants, but when exposed to human cancer cells, they found that the red onion extract killed 3 to 4 times as many cells. The findings are published in Food Research International. When it comes to pregnancies, or lack thereof, how long should couples wait before seeking the help of a fertility expert? The answer is, if you're over 35, wait about 6 months before you get help. If you're under 35, you can wait about a year. If women have a history of gynecological problems, it should be sooner. When it comes to getting pregnant, male fertility is just as important as female fertility.
A lot of couples are surprised to find that male infertility is just as important as female in factoring in causes of infertility. So 30 to 40% of the couples that I see will have some identifiable male factor.
Trying to get pregnant can be stressful on couples, so whenever possible, it's helpful to try and reduce tension as well. Always a good idea. It's 10 to 6 right now. Up next, we'll update the local news headlines and also what was seen on Siesta Key. A picture after this.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free. Services.com. A-N-D services.com.
Is your old garage door stuck or broken? Would a new one give you a lift? Let Precision Door Overhead Garage Door Service of Sarasota come to the rescue with prompt and affordable repair service. Replacement doors come with an array of styles and colors, and they are rated to meet and exceed Florida standards. From estimates to installation, your satisfaction is our priority. If you're not 100% satisfied with any product, service, or installation, we will make it right, because Precision Door Service is a name you can trust.
Are you paying too much for your cable or satellite TV? The U.S. government passed a bill mandating free over-the-air digital transmission of all broadcast network television channels. That means with the new TV Freeway digital antenna, you can get free HD programming from your favorite broadcast networks 24/7 without a bill. You just plug it into the back of your TV and start watching all of your favorite broadcast programs for free. There are no contracts to sign, no hidden fees, and no monthly fees. Just free HD broadcast TV. Take it with you anywhere. Call or go online now to get your TV Freeway stick for the incredibly low price of only $14.99. But wait, call or click now and you can get a second TV Freeway stick for a second TV. Just pay a separate fee, but you have to order right now.
Call 1-800-809-5196 to get your TV Freeway. Call now or go to tvfreeway.com. So call 1-800-809-5196. This offer's not in any store. Call now.
Who else has been taking your prescriptions? Keep your medicine and your family safe and secure. Mind your meds. To learn how we can help, visit the Partnership for Drug-Free Kids at drugfree.org.
There was this big bruise on my friend's face. I didn't want to see it. I didn't want to think her own nephew could have hit her.
I didn't want to see it. My mother's bank account was emptied, and her caregiver had taken control of it.
I didn't want to see it. My father's refrigerator. There was hardly anything in it. That's unusual for him.
It's tough to see that a senior citizen is being abused, physically, emotionally, sexually, or financially. Elder abuse is a crime.
So see the signs. Stop the crimes.
I'm Alan Cohn. United in the face of tragedy, Congress is denouncing an attack on its members as an investigation into President Trump intensifies.
Tonight on ABC 7 News at 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free, and services.com, A-N-D, services.com.
Welcome back, 5:53 now, checking Suncoast headlines this morning. One of the drivers from a three-car crash earlier this week near the Siesta Bridge has passed away of his injuries. Police believe that 57-year-old Guy Theron was speeding before hitting two other cars near Heigl Avenue. This Bradenton man is charged with killing his own dog. Manatee County Sheriff deputies say he confessed to the stabbing. And there are plans for a new Jimmy Buffett-themed housing development on State Road 64 near Perico Island. It could open as soon as next spring, with prices starting at $400,000. Well, the number one beach in America attracts more than just people, it appears. A local photographer named Jake Drost took this picture of a bobcat enjoying a walk on Siesta Key Beach. Now, wildlife officials say bobcat sightings are not unusual on Siesta Key, but I don't know. I've lived here quite a while. I've never heard of a bobcat, and I also wonder why those people by the water are hardly even noticing the bobcat. So I'm not buying into this one. What are your thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, I guess they have been known to be spotted on the beach before. I know, I think there was one not too long ago spotted on Longboat Key, actually.
A bobcat.
I don't know how they get out to the key, but yeah. Somehow they find their way. And they're big.
I don't think they're dangerous.
Yeah, I mean, maybe you can tame them, but maybe when they're like little kittens. But I think they're, you know,
now,
they're,
I know that fishermen go out to South Siesta Key late at night and catch shark. I had no idea there was shark available.
I know there's hammerheads.
News to me.
But, yeah, I think they say you don't want to go swimming in the Gulf at dusk.
Yeah.
Because that can be a problem
with
the sharks coming in. Anyway, all right, let's check out the weather. Today, about a 20 to 30% chance of shower activity. There's some showers out in the Gulf of Mexico right now. They're tracking onshore. They're going to be light. If anything does develop that's going to be heavier, that'll be isolated. And then by this afternoon, with the heating of the day, we'll get those showers and storms developing. But those will be inland. And then for Saturday and Sunday, the Father's Day weekend, I think we're going to have fairly tame weather. But things change by next Monday and Tuesday and Wednesday and Thursday because of a southwest flow coming our way that's going to bring more moisture and showers and storms.
That looks like more than the usual typical summertime pattern, all that rain.
Yeah, because that's tropical moisture being fed right in from the southwest.
Boy, a lot of rain the past couple weeks. We'll update the forecast, update local news headlines, and check traffic as well in 2 minutes. Stay with us.